Hello friends, welcome to CyberCat Solutions. In this session, we are going to see four different methods to track points. So the first one is object snap tracking, second one is temporary tracking point, third one is from, fourth one is point filters. First of all, object snap tracking. Here, there is one rectangle and a circle. The circle center point is 3 units vertically away from this corner and 5 units horizontally away from this corner. Let us say if you have to draw this circle directly, so how to draw that one without drawing any reference lines or reference objects? Directly how to draw this circle? So start the circle command, circle, and then type TRA, that is tracking, and then it is asking first tracking point. So take the corner point as first tracking point and drag your cursor upwards and type 3 and press enter so that the tracking point will be changed 3 units vertically away from the selected corner. Now move your cursor horizontally towards right side and type 5 at the command prompt and press enter so that the tracking points moves 5 units horizontally towards right side. Now we have got the point required for the center of the circle to be drawn. So just press enter to finish the tracking, and it is asking specify radius of the circle. Simply type the radius and press enter so that the circle is drawn directly without drawing any reference objects. Let us check the vertical and horizontal distances between this corner and circle. So I am taking vertical difference. You can see it is 3 units. Similarly, say horizontal distance 5 units, that you can see. So like this, using tracking, we can draw objects directly without reference lines. Similarly, if you want to draw a circle in the mid of this rectangle, that is, let us say if you draw a diagonal, the middle point will be here. So without drawing this diagonal, how can we take the center point of a circle at this middle point? So take circle command CI and it is asking center point. Now type TRA tracking, initiate the tracking and press enter. Now it is asking first tracking point. Pick the middle point on the base side and move your cursor upwards until you see this tracking line comes up, and then go to the left and pick the middle point, and the cursor point changes from bottom to the center of this rectangle. Now we have got the point required. Simply press enter to finish the tracking. And now the tracking ends and the command comes back to the circle, and it is asking radius of the circle. Simply enter the radius so that you can see the circle is drawn exactly at the center of this rectangle. So like this, temporary tracking is very useful and that will ease our life in drafting. Okay, sorry, this is object snap tracking. Then temporary tracking. What is the use of temporary tracking? Let us say if you want to draw a line 5 units away from this corner, vertically aligned with this vertical line. So let us see that. Take the line command, type L at the command prompt and press enter. Now to take the tracking, simply pick shift button plus right click so that you will get shortcut menu button, shortcut object snap menu. In that, the first one is temporary tracking point. Pick that option. Now it is asking pick the O track point. Simply click over here. The same thing can be activated by pressing tracking button over here. Here you can see this. If you press this button, automatically the tracking will be switched on. That can also be used for this. So simply click the tracking button and move your cursor upwards. You can see a green tracking line comes up. So whatever the distance you want from this corner, simply type the distance, say 3 units, so that in the same alignment, a point will be taken 3 units away from that corner. Now simply pick the second point for the line so that you will get the line 3 units away from this corner. Just check that one by placing a dimension. Let us see the same thing how to do using this OTrack method. Just click this OTrack so that the object snap tracking will be switched on. Now take either circle or line command. I am taking circle command CI, and I want the circle to be drawn 3 units away from this corner towards upside. So go to the corner and move your cursor little away so that you can see the tracking vector in the green color, and just move your cursor upwards, type the distance to be taken between corner and circle center so that the point will be snapped automatically with the given distance. Now you can enter the radius of this circle. So if you want to check the distance between these two points, you can check that one. So this is how we can use tracking method, that is temporary tracking. Now let us see another method, from. So this is also a kind of tracking only. Let us see one example. So if you want to move this circle 3 units away from this corner, upwards or horizontally rightwards, you can do that using from. So let us see how to do that. Simply select the circle, click the center point, shift right click and select from, and click the from point, that is this corner, and move your cursor towards which direction you want to move that circle, and enter the distance, simply say 3 units, so that you can see a circle, that circle is moved 3 units horizontally away from that corner. Let us check the distance, that is 3 units. Okay, so this is from method, that is also very useful. We can use from method in different commands. Let us say I want to stretch this rectangle so that its width must become 3 units. So take stretch command and select the part to be stretched like this, and press enter to finish the selection, and take the base point. Now let me take from, so shift right click and take from point, and the width of this rectangle from this end point I want it to become 3 units, so type 3 and press enter. Now you can see the distance between these two points is 3 units. Like this we can use from point in different commands, point filter. So this is very useful. Let us say I have started drawing lines like this. So first point, second point, third point and fourth point, I want to take the x coordinate of this point and y coordinate of this point. In such cases, simply switch off the object snap tracking. Now simply shift plus right click and go to point filters and take dot x. Now dot x of which point? So this point is the dot x, and to say the same y which is currently being used, type at the rate at the command prompt and press enter so that that point is taken. Now simply take close option. Now you can see that is exactly with the same x position and same y position of this side. So this can also be used for the y coordinate also. So let us see that option also. So take line command, pick the first point, second point, third point and fourth point. Now I want the y coordinate of this point and x coordinate of this point. So to take that one, shift right click, go to point filters and pick dot y option and click this point, so that dot y of this means the coordinate of this point has been taken. To say the x coordinate at same location, simply type at the rate at the command prompt and press enter so that that point will be calculated, and you can finish the command by clicking close. So like this, point filters are also very useful in drafting. Friends, hope you understood how to use object snap tracking, temporary tracking, from point as well as point filters. Okay friends, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching and welcome to the next session.